Hey everyone, Darren Voros here. Today I want to walk you through the 10 lessons that I've learned while scaling and growing my real estate investing business. Many of us have aspirations of being full-time investors and becoming financially free, but unless you can grow your portfolio at a steady rate, it's hard to make real estate investing your profession and get to your goals on time. The investors that have been able to do this successfully have taken a systematic approach to growing their portfolio. I know this because in the beginning, I was one of those investors that didn't have a system, the education, or the network to successfully be able to grow my business. But in time, I learned what I needed to do in order to be able to grow, and I'm glad to pass that on to you so that you don't have to go through the same growing pains that I did. So I'll do my best to condense what I've learned over 18 years of real estate investing into this one video in order for you to be able to successfully scale and grow your real estate investing business. Wish me luck. Before we get into it today, if you haven't done so already, you can subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and please feel free to leave comments and questions below for me. You can also hit that like button, which really helps out me and my channel and helps YouTube's algorithm put this video in front of the right audience. And now without further ado, let's get into it. The easiest way for me to show you how to grow your real estate investing business is to tell you a little bit about my investing story. I'm like every other investor out there, which means that I've made a lot of mistakes in my career. So I'll be transparent about the things that I would change. On the other hand, my business has been very successful, so I also want to share with you what elements have made the biggest difference for me. Let me start with a very quick overview. I bought my very first house in 2002 in Red Deer, Alberta. The idea with this house was I was going to buy it from the builder, brand new, finish the basement, and then sell it to somebody else, make a profit, and move on. The problem was I couldn't sell it for the price that I wanted to, so I ended up renting it out long term. The second house I bought was in 2004. I also bought this one from a builder, and the plan was to renovate the basement, but I was planning to live in it because I was working in the area. If I wasn't working in the area in the future, I just planned to rent it out long term. In 2006, I decided to sell the very first property that I bought in 2002, and I took the money from those profits that I made on that transaction, and I went and I bought a property in Toronto in 2006 to flip it, and I sold the property in 2007. Which brings me to the first lesson that I learned when it comes to growing your real estate portfolio, and that is that there's no such thing as get rich quick in real estate investing. Because I thought we were gonna buy this house for around $340,000, put $60,000 into it, and sell it for $500,000 and make $100,000 profit. What actually happened was we bought it for $340,000, we spent almost $100,000, and by the time we got closing costs, realtor fees, everything else in there, we ended up making about $15,000 on that transaction. It was still profitable, but it was very different than the actual money that I thought I was gonna make in the beginning. And if you calculate the amount of time and effort that I put into that transaction, I would have been better off getting a job making minimum wage. I would have made more money. So when I sold that flip in 2007, essentially I got that same money back from buying my very first property, and I went and I took that money and I bought a new condo to live in. So up to this point, I had purchased four properties, I had sold two of them, so I had two properties in my portfolio after being a real estate investor for 5 years. It should also be mentioned that up to this point, I had no strategy in real estate investing. The only strategy that I was using was trial and error. I had no system, no education, and no network. In 2007, I read a book. It was called Real Estate Investing in Canada by Don R. Campbell. And it changed the way I looked at investing. If you haven't read that book, I'll leave a link to it in the description below. The book promoted a systematic approach, heavy on due diligence and analysis. And like many other investors, I read one book, thought I was an expert, and went and bought another property. This time I purchased my first multi-unit property. It was three units in an up-and-coming neighborhood called The Junction in Toronto. Immediately after I bought this house, I went to work on it with various renovations, all of which were done by me personally. I learned a ton of renovation skills, but had little time for anything else as I was still holding down a full-time job, managing my properties myself, and doing renovations when necessary. And this brings me to my second lesson, which is if you want to grow your real estate investing business, you have to work on your business and not in it. Yes, I was saving myself some money by doing my own renovations, but if I'm working 40 to 50 hours a week on the job site, I can't step back, manage my business, and really grow it from that perspective. Fast forward to 2011. I sold the second property that I bought in 2004 because it was becoming a pain to manage and it wasn't growing in value or generating cash flow. I sold the property for exactly what I had into it at that point because, again, I just purchased without really knowing what I was doing. I had rented it the whole time, so I'd been paying down the mortgage, but I didn't have cash flow because I didn't purchase this property with cash flow in mind. So I got my original down payment back and what I'd paid down on my mortgage, And ultimately, I ended up with a check for about $75,000. So at this point, I had added another property to my portfolio, but I also sold one. So after 9 years of being a real estate investor, I had three properties in my portfolio. And the third lesson I learned, if you want to grow, is create a system and follow your system to a T. With this new money that I had from selling my property, I wanted to start to make smart investments. I wanted to take this more seriously, get educated, and surround myself with like-minded people. I joined an organization called RAIN, the Real Estate Investment Network, and I went to monthly meetups, I followed their education system, and I tried to engage in their various platforms as much as I possibly could. This helped me out a lot because in 2013, I bought my fourth house. It was in Red Deer, Alberta. In 2013, I bought my fifth house, also in Red Deer, Alberta. And in 2014, I bought my sixth house, also in Red Deer, Alberta. Which brings me to the fourth lesson I learned in growing my portfolio, which is getting educated on real estate investing can be a huge game changer. In 9 years, I had acquired three properties, and in 3 years, I doubled my portfolio, what had taken me 9 years to get to that point. So at this time, I was now 12 years into being a real estate investor, and I had six properties in my portfolio. Three out of the six of those properties that I had purchased, I joint venture partnered with my parents on, which was hugely helpful. And the fifth lesson I want to pass on is having partnerships can help you achieve in real estate investing what you may not be able to achieve on your own. In 2014, I decided to leave the Real Estate Investing Network because, to be honest with you, the networking aspect wasn't exactly what I was hoping for. I also wasn't attending any of the meetings or consuming much of their content, so it didn't seem to make much sense for me to be putting out money every month for something that I wasn't using. In 2015, I heard of a new organization called Keyspire. Scott McGilvery, the host of Income Property, was one of the spokespeople and also one of the co-founders of the organization. So like many other people, I went to a two-hour free session, attended a three-day workshop, and paid $18,000 to become a member of Keyspire's network. And the sixth lesson I learned when it comes to growing your real estate investing business is that when you spend $18,000 on education, networking, and coaching, you're really motivated to get your money's worth. So after participating in the three-day workshop and speaking with my different coaches, I decided to take the plunge. I decided to try to become a full-time real estate investor. At the same time, I distinctly remember learning about two unique things that I'd never heard about before. Did they exist? Yes. Maybe it was just the right time for me to hear them, but it was something that I don't remember hearing in the past. The first thing was using private capital and creative financing on my renovation projects. And the second thing was being able to use my registered funds, my RRSPs and my TFSAs, in real estate investing to invest in private lending and land development. And this brings me to the seventh lesson I learned in growing my real estate portfolio, and that's that you don't know what you don't know. You can think you know everything there is to know, and if that's the case, you're dead in the water because even the most savvy real estate investors out there learn new skills all the time because real estate investing is changing all the time. Once I decided to dive in as a full-time investor, things started to move a little bit quicker. Within that year, I bought three more houses, all of which had joint venture partners on. I invested in a land development deal with my RRSPs, and I got into a syndicated private lending mortgage with some additional cash that I had. In 12 years, I had six properties in my portfolio, and in less than 1 year, I added five more real estate transactions. I almost doubled my portfolio in 1 year, what had taken me 12 years to do up to that point. Which is the eighth lesson I learned in growing my portfolio, and that's that you have to spend money to make money. The caveat to that is it doesn't have to always be your own money. But I can almost guarantee that if you spend money on your education, building your network, and your business, it will pay for itself 10 times over. Could I have done this on my own? Yes, absolutely. Would I have done it in the same time frame? No. Are there free resources out there that are available to you? Absolutely. This YouTube channel is one of them. Are they all created equal? Absolutely not. But at some point, if you want to be successful at anything, you're going to need to spend your money on your education, your systems, and your ability to scale. And you cannot do that for free. And if I had some kind of course, I would definitely try to sell it to you right now. But I don't. Will I create one in the future? Maybe, but for now, I'm enjoying putting out free content for my audience, and I hope that you're seeing some value in what I do. If you do, if you can hit the like button below and leave me a comment, I would really appreciate that. I can tell you about two things that I've been working on though, because they are super cool and have a lot to do with our topic today. In early 2020, when I really wanted to grow my business and scale it, I started looking for an elite group of investors to collaborate with. I wanted to find a group that met online bi-weekly for accountability, and perhaps got together 2 times per year in person in an immersive setting to further my education and grow my network. I wanted to sit in a room with like-minded individuals and be educated and inspired by guest speakers that are the best minds in the business of real estate investing and entrepreneurship. And then at the end of each day, I wanted to find a group that would sit together, eat together, maybe share a cocktail or two, and continue to talk about our businesses, share great stories, and create friendships. I'll tell you, I searched high and low in Canada, and it doesn't exist. So, we created it. I'll be very honest with you, my strengths do not lie in event facilitation. So I decided to seek out partners that have strengths that I do not have, which is my 9th lesson when it comes to growing your real estate investing portfolio. Figure out what you do best and focus your energy there. For everything else, create partnerships or hire someone to do that work for you. Enter Randy and Steve of the Reinvestors. And if you haven't checked out Randy and Steve's Facebook or YouTube channel, I'll link that below. They were also guests on this channel, and I'll link that video there as well. Randy and Steve run amazing events and have a ton of experience in this field. So we've partnered up to create the Synergy Mastermind. Our primary objective of this mastermind is to focus on 3 elements: collaboration, education, and scaling your business. This group is set up for seasoned investors who have 3 or more deals under their belt and who are looking to grow their portfolios significantly with the support of a killer group of investors. If you'd like more information on the mastermind, go to synergymastermind.ca and you can apply online. We're only accepting 30 people into this group, so get your application in as soon as you can because spots are filling up very quickly. I know that many of you are just getting started in real estate investing and this may not be a fit for you yet. And if that's the case, I wanted to mention that I do offer private one-on-one coaching and a mentorship program. A lot of you have been reaching out to me on Facebook and Instagram about my coaching program, and I wish I could take everyone on, but I do keep this to a very limited group because I want to make sure that I give my coaching clients the attention that they deserve. Having said that, I am going to open up 5 new spots, so if you're interested, I'll leave a link in the description below. Which leads me to my 10th lesson when it comes to growing your real estate investing business. At some point, if you really want to grow and scale, you'll need a coach and a mentor. It doesn't necessarily have to be me, but if you can find someone who's really going to guide you on the path, you'll get to your goals just that much faster and achieve financial freedom just that much sooner. So now let's fast forward one last time to 2020. As I mentioned at the beginning of the year, I wanted to change how I did business, and I started to look at what I could do differently. The first thing I realized was I had to grow my network, which is why I've started my YouTube channel and the mastermind. I also had to continue to learn, constantly educating myself on new ideas, strategies, techniques, and business practices. And last but not least, I had to adjust my thinking. I had to create an abundance mindset. There's more than enough deals out there for everyone. There's more than enough money out there. And if I can create an environment around me that is open to that, there is truly an opportunity to see growth in my business like I've never seen before. So if you really want to scale and grow your real estate investing business, create a system and follow it to a T. Get educated, surround yourself with a network of like-minded people, and take on an abundance mindset, and you'll see a significant shift in the way that you do business. Oh, and one more thing, make sure you hit that like button and the subscribe button, and you can also hit the notification bell, and feel free to leave comments and questions below for me. You can also follow me on Facebook, Instagram, check out my website at darrenvoros.com. With that, I'll say thank you guys so much for watching. I wish you the best of success in your real estate investing journey, and I look forward to hearing your success stories very soon.